day, show me the way, one day at a time.
I'm only human, I'm just a woman. Help me believe in what I could be and all that I am. Show me the stairway that I have to climb. Lord, for my sake, teach me to take one day at a time.
One day at a time.
Sweet Jesus,
that's all I'm asking of you.
Just give me the strength to do every day what I have to do.
Yesterday's gone, sweet Jesus, and tomorrow may never be mine. Lord, help me today, show me the way, one day at a time.
Do you remember when you walked among men? Well, Jesus, you know, if you're looking below, that it's worse now than then. Oh, there's pushing and shoving,
and it's crowding.
Teach me to take one day at a time.
One day at a time.
Sweet Jesus,
that's all I'm asking of you.
Just give me the strength to do everything what I have to do.
Yesterday gone,
sweet Jesus,
and tomorrow may never be mine.
Lord, help me today, show me the way, one day at a time.
Lord, help me today, show me the way, one day at a time.
When you're up on the mountain, you've got peace of mind like you've never known. But things change when you're down in the valley. Don't lose faith, for you're never alone.
For the God on the mountain is still God in the valley. When things go wrong, He'll make them right.
When you're up on the mountain, talk comes so easy. When life's at its best, now it's down in the valley. swear your face is really put to the test. For the God on the mountain is still God in the valley. When things go wrong, He'll make them right. And the God of the good times is still God in the bad times. The God of the day is still God in the
Savior say thy strength indeed is small. Child of weakness, watch and pray. Find in me thine all in all. Jesus paid it all. All to him I owe.
Crimson.
white as snow.
Hi, this is Todd Fields with Worship Circle. I want to thank you for watching the live recording from our rest retreat. This thing we do call Worship Circle is for you as a worship leader. We know that ministry can be taxing on you and your family, and oftentimes we need a place to jump into to be known, to be loved on, and be cared for. Our groups are open now. You can apply at worshipcircle.com/program. You can get more information there. And we'd love for you to pray about it and apply. Your application is not a commitment. It's just a chance for us to see you do what you do, where God has you planted right now. But we want you to know that you're loved and not alone. That's our purpose. And that we're with you, even though we can't see you, all around the world, one army of worshipers for the kingdom of God in our lifetime, joining heaven and earth. We care about you. We're here for you. Apply now at worshipcircle.com/program.
Everything what I had to do. got peace of mind like you've never known. But things change when you're down in the valley. Don't lose faith, for you're never alone.
For the God on the mountain is still God in the valley. When things go wrong, He'll make them right.
When you're up on the mountain, the talk comes so easy. When life's at its best, now it's down in the valley of trials and temptation. That's where your faith to the test.
For the God on the mountain is still God in the valley. When things go wrong, He'll make them right. And the God of the good times is still God.
Still God in the night, the God of
Jesus. Do you know this song?
No.
Okay. Okay, God bless you all.
Amen.
We are so thankful to the Lord for this opportunity. We thank the Lord for his resurrection. We thank the Lord to stand again in front of you. May the Lord bless you all.
Amen.
The Lord bless also all the parents. We are again this morning to speak about the Holy Spirit. Before starting, let's start stand up. We will start our Sunday school today. Make yourself ready in the spirit of the Lord, in the atmosphere. We want to get into spirit now. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Siyabonga. Amen. Siyabonga. Amen. Siyabonga. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Okay, we all going to pray. Close your eyes, lift your hand to the Lord, and let us pray together. Merci Seigneur Jésus, tu es le roi des rois, le Seigneur des seigneurs, El Shaddai, El Elyon, El Shivon, le tout en tout, le grand Jéhovah de l'Ancien Testament, Jésus-Christ le même hier, aujourd'hui, éternellement. Ce matin, nous te sommes vraiment reconnaissants pour les privilèges que tu nous donnes de venir encore devant ta face, Seigneur, t'élever, t'adorer, te magnifier. Nous voyons ces beaux jours avec ce soleil qui est sorti, nous rappelons ces grands jours où, pendant que le soleil s'élevait, toi aussi tu étais ressuscité. La mort ne pouvait pas te retenir. Oh Jésus, tu étais ressuscité. Et nous commémorons encore ta résurrection ce matin. Oh, tu es monté au ciel, tu es assis à la droite de ton Père, et tu as fait descendre ton esprit afin que cela puisse entrer à nous. C'est pourquoi ce matin, nous allons encore parler aux enfants, tournant toujours sur le même sujet. Notre désir est que tout enfant soit baptisé du Saint-Esprit et qu'il puisse faire face à cette génération qui se meurt. Bénis encore, Seigneur, pour tous les parents, tous les enfants, notre pasteur et toutes les épouses dans le monde entier. Pardonne nos péchés, nos manquements, Père. Utilise-nous pour ta propre gloire. Au nom du Seigneur Jésus. Amen. Thank you. You may be seated now. We're going to first sing a song and then we're going to go to our subject. We walk, walk. Walk in the light, we walk, walk, walk in the light, we walk, walk, walk in the light of the Lord. Do you know that song? I want you to clap your hands. You're in the church now. We walk, walk, walk in the light, we walk, walk, walk in the light, we walk. Walk, walk in the light of the Lord. We walk, walk, walk in the light. We walk, walk, walk in the light. We walk, walk, walk in the light of the Lord. Come and go with me to my Father's house, to my Father's house. To my Father's house, come and go with me to my Father's house. There is joy, joy, joy. Praise God, hallelujah. Praise God, amen. Praise God, hallelujah. Praise God, amen. Praise God, hallelujah. Praise God, amen. God. Jesus, we are here. Jesus, we are here. Jesus, we are here. We are here for you. Praise God, hallelujah. Praise God, amen. Praise God, hallelujah. Praise God, amen. God is good
all the time.
All the time?
God is good.
Are you ready now to listen to the word of God?
Yes.
Okay, we're going to read our Bible in John 3. John chapter 3 and verse 3, just short. John 3:3. Are you ready?
Yeah.
I'm just waiting for you. Open your Bible. Okay, stand up. I'm going to read. John 3, verse 3. Jesus answered him, "Truly, truly, I say to you, unless one is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God." Let me start in the beginning. Now, there was a man of the Pharisee named Nicodemus, a ruler of the Jews. This man came to Jesus by night, and he said to him, "Rabbi, we know that you are a teacher, come from God, for no one can do this sign that you do unless God is with him." Jesus answered him, "Truly, truly, I say to you, unless one is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God." Nicodemus said to him, "How can a man be born when he is old? Can he enter a second time into his mother's womb and be born?" Jesus answered, "Truly, truly, I say to you, unless one is born of water and spirit, he cannot enter the kingdom of God." I'm going to stop there. Okay, we're going to take our second verse. Our second verse is in Ezekiel 36. We're going to verse 26. "And I will give you a new heart, a new spirit I will put within you, and I will remove the heart of stone from your flesh and give you a heart of flesh." Ezekiel 36, verse 26, it says, I'm repeating, "I will give you a new heart." So God will give us a new heart, a new spirit I will put within you. I will remove the heart of stone and from the flesh, and I give you a heart of flesh. May God bless you. You may be seated. Okay. You can sit now. We're speaking about the Holy Ghost. Now, we just read the Bible right now. There was a man called Nicodemus. In John 3:3, was a man called Nicodemus. So Nicodemus was a ruler of the Jews. He came by night to our Lord Jesus Christ, and he asked him question. He said, "Jesus, all the sign that you are doing is really true." But he came by night. Just notice that he came by night. He didn't want to come during the day because he was afraid that they might see him. He came by night. And he said, "Rabbi, we know that you are a teacher. We know instead of asking a question by himself, but he wanted to add other people, say, we know. The Holy Ghost is not a matter of we know. It's an individual thing, you and God. Not you with your dad, your man. No, it's about yourself. The salvation is about yourself. Are you listening to me?
Yes.
It's about yourself. Not mommy, not daddy, but you need to take a decision yourself. Okay. So he said, we know. Instead of saying, I know, but he said, we know. We know that all the sin that you're doing is really coming from God. Jesus answered, truly, truly, I say to you, unless one is born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. So what is the kingdom of God? It's the Holy Spirit in you. But for you to get to come to the kingdom of God, you need to be born again. Are you with me?
Yes.
To born again is not about going into your mother womb again. No, it's not that. As Nicodemus was saying, I'm old like this. How can I go into my mother womb and be born again? To be born again is to die on yourself. To die about the worldly things. To accept the Lord Jesus Christ himself. Okay? What is to be born again? Is to die in yourself. You die about your mind. You die on whatever it worldly, you need to give up. To be born again. To receive now the Spirit of God. Are you with me?
Yes.
Good. Now listen. Look at my drawing here. God, we human beings, we've got a body. Okay? The spirit and the soul. This is how we human beings are being formed by God. God created us in three beings. We've got the body. Becky, are you with me? Eloy?
Yes.
The spirit and the soul. God wants to dwell in the soul. And where the soul is located? In your heart. Okay? In our external body here, we've got five senses. We can see, we can hear, we can taste, we can feel, we can smell. Okay? It's five senses. I can see you, I can speak to you through my mouth. There's a spirit over there. The spirit, we've got imagination, conscience, affection. We can't see what is in your spirit. Okay. When I say I love you, can you see that love?
No.
No. Okay. When I dream, can you see my dream?
No.
No. So all that is into the spirit. But God wants to live in our soul. And in the soul, we've got only two things. We've got faith or doubt. Okay? So, that's why we're speaking about the new birth. It needs to start in the soul there. You take a decision, as the pastor was talking last time, that there's no grandson. There's no, God doesn't have a grandson. There's only son and daughter of God. So we're talking about Nicodemus. Nicodemus came to Jesus and said, really, it's really true. that whatever you're doing, you say is true. But Jesus answered to him, you need to be born again. You need to be
born again.
I'm going to give you something else, another example. If a corn, you know a corn?
Yes.
A corn expected to live again. What must we do with that corn? That corn must be planted again. But we're going to plant it, it's going to die in the sand, and then it's gonna go again. So the same with you. If you are expected to live with God again, to have eternal life, you need to die of whatever it in the world here. Okay. You die from evil, you die from lie, you die, take away all this stuff. Hypocrisy, you die into yourself, all this bad cartoon, you die from your old friend, you need to separate with them, then you are expected to live again. Are you with me? Are you with me?
Yes.
Okay. There was a man in the town of Brother Barnum. In that time, he received the Holy Spirit, like you, they pray for you, and you receive the Holy Spirit, isn't it? Now, they ask him a question. What happened to you when you received the Holy Spirit? He said, there's two dogs that fight in my soul, in my heart. There's two dogs that fighting, the black dog and the white dog. Then they ask him a question. Who often wins? Is it the black or the white? So that man replied, it depends on the dog that I feed the most. Okay, it depends on the dog that I feed the most. So after receiving the Holy Spirit, there will be a war now between good and evil. Which dog are going to win?
White.
Are you sure? So if you want that dog to win, what must you do?
Feed it.
How are you gonna feed that dog? You feed the dog with the word of God. Okay. You feed that dog with the word of God. You're listening the word of God, the song that coming from God, you read your Bible every day, you pray every day. That is the only way you can feed the white dog. But if you feed the black dog, what's gonna happen?
The black dog
gonna win. And God gives you the Holy Spirit for you to be His witness. Okay. God is looking for evil to stand from the sin of this world. And at the end of the world, God gonna say, look at my son Eloi. Look at my son Elim. Look my daughter Becky. Look my daughter Rose. They didn't pattern themselves with the worldly things. Are you with me?
Yes.
Yes. God is looking for evil. God is looking for His children to stand up, to say, I'm not going to defile my body. I'm not going to watch this bad movie. I'm not going to swear. I'm not going to let myself go around with bad friend. I'm not going to watch this bad movie that's gonna defile my mind. God is looking for these children filled with the Holy Spirit that gonna stand with the Word. Are you with me?
Yes.
Because you are children of the King. You are not like the world. you receive His Spirit. For those who didn't make a decision yet, I'm appealing to you. Let's say tonight, if it's your last day, and when the pastor calls you and says to you that, come, you're going to receive the Holy Spirit, you say, I'm not ready. Let's say today, it's your last day. Mm-hmm. Where are you going to go? Are you going to go to heaven or to
heaven?
So, do not wait until the last day. Are you with me? Becky, are you with me? Do not wait. Take a stand. Step up. There was a, don't wait. You remember the story of Brother Branham was shot, and then he was taken to the hospital. At that time, he was not a Christian yet. Yes, he didn't receive Jesus as his Savior yet at that time. He was still young. So they shot him. When they shot him, they took him to the hospital, then he was dying. He was explaining that he was like falling into the pit. While he was falling in that pit, he cried, Mommy, there was no mommy there. Daddy, there was no daddy there. He saw evil spirit that was coming with long nails. And at that time he promised to God, God, if you heal me, I'm gonna save you this time. He took a decision. Okay? Don't wait until you become in that state for you to say, okay, I'm taking the decision now to follow Jesus. Don't wait like Samson. You know the story of Samson?
Yeah.
Until his eyes was gone, then he said, Lord, once more, do not wait. Okay, we don't know, maybe tomorrow morning Jesus may come. So if you're not ready, if you don't have the Holy Spirit, no Holy Spirit, no rapture. Repeat.
No Holy Spirit, no rapture.
No Holy Spirit, no rapture. Again.
No Holy Spirit, no rapture.
That is it. If you don't have the Holy Spirit, you will not be raptured. So, what Jesus meant here, it was we need to die in ourselves, our arrogance. When we're not respecting our parents, we need to ask God, change me. My desire is to respect my parents, to honor them. There's some kid, when the parents are there, they want to pretend that they are good. I've saw it. For example, mommy said that, okay, today I want you to not watch any movie. I want you to be in prayer. So mommy left or daddy left, go to work. Now you start to look, oh, normally mommy come back at 4 o'clock. Then you switch off the TV. Is it good?
No.
That is hypocrisy. God doesn't want hypocrite. You need to be sincere about yourself. Okay, let me read some quote of Brother Branham here. Then we're gonna go a little bit further. Be patient with me. Okay, but when I'm in the conference, you must be born again. Everything has to die. All your thinking you ever was or ever expect to be, your life, everything else die away. And then the Holy Spirit come in. That when you take off your head, your shoes, stand before God. Nothing in my arm I bring simply to the cross are clean. That way Moses has to come. Where he could obey what God say. This is one of the scriptures Brother Branham is giving to us, that we need to die in our soul in order to get the true Holy Spirit. And the Holy Spirit mustn't be on the outside, but it needs to start from in your soul and show up outside. They teach us what is the Holy Spirit. Mama Kabea teach you what is the Holy Spirit. It's a gift. It's what?
A
gift from God. Another answer?
It's a key to go to
heaven. It's a key to go to heaven. It's a ticket. Yes, Vicky?
It's a transforming power.
It's a transforming power. What else?
Counselor.
What else? What is the Holy Spirit? Ticket from God. A gift from God. How do you receive it?
By
confessing your sin. How do you know that you receive it?
It will change your life.
It will change your ways, your life. Okay. The Holy Spirit is God Himself in you. It's God Himself in you. He's our comforter. The Holy Spirit is the key to heaven, as you mentioned. The Holy Spirit is our advocate. Okay. When you do something wrong, you confess your sin. And the Holy Spirit as the advocate will intercede for you. But if you do something on purpose, God doesn't want that is sin. Because when you are at the edge of accountability, when you know what is wrong and right, God starts to count your sin. Okay? And the only way to come back is by repentance. Mama Kabe will show you how to repent yourself. Okay? The word of God also tell you how to repent. Do not hide anything. Is there anything that you're hiding?
No.
Becky? Is there something that you're hiding? Yeah. Do not hide anything. That way you come up, you take a decision. The Holy Spirit, the promise, you need to believe. That way the soul, in your soul, there is a faith or a doubt. You need to believe that God has promised you. You need to desire. If you don't have a desire, then nothing will happen. Okay. For those who are still waiting to take a decision, come back quick. Come back quick. Look at what is going on the world today. I'm giving you something else like Daniel. Look at Daniel. When Daniel saw that thing were going wrong, when Daniel was seeing that the promise of God was needed to be accomplished, what Daniel did? Daniel started to pray. He was praying 3 times a day. How many times?
3 times.
Yes. Daniel stood, confessed his sin, confessed his parents' sins. Daniel didn't like stay in a position of I don't care. No. Daniel started to pray because he saw by the scripture that the time is finished. And whatever we're seeing now, we're seeing that God will come soon, isn't it?
Yeah.
Jesus will return on the earth soon. The rapture is almost at the door. Are you with me? So it's time for us to pray, to keep that atmosphere. Those who didn't receive the Holy Spirit, keep on asking, keep on knocking, keep on praying, keep on seeking. Because the Holy Spirit, you don't just sit. You need to seek for the Holy Spirit. Are you with me? You seek for the Holy Spirit. And God Himself will lead you out too. Are you with me?
Yes.
Good. Okay. We're gonna finish now. I'm gonna take another scripture, another quotation. So, when our Lord Jesus Christ received the Holy Spirit, do you know that Jesus also received the Holy Spirit?
Yes.
When he received that Holy Spirit, there was something happened. The devil took him into the mountain and tested him. He tested him with what? With the word of God. He came to him and said, if you worship me, I will give you all this world. But Jesus being the word, Jesus being God, he knew that it was a temptation coming from the devil. And Jesus replied with the word. That's why you need also to know the word, to read your Bible. When you will be in front of the devil or a bad friend coming to you with evil story, you're gonna stand with the word. You will say, I'm not gonna do it because the word of God tells me to do this. Are you with me?
Yes.
Now there's a war. There's a war between your flesh and the soul. You must be careful now. You must be careful. The devil will tell you, go and take that 100 rand and hide it. What are you gonna tell him?
No.
No! I cannot lie, I cannot steal. Are you with me?
Yes.
When the devil come and say, I must be disobedient to my parent, what are you gonna do?
No.
You're gonna quote him the word. You say, in Ephesians 6, the Bible tell me I must obey my parents. That's how you stand. That's how you keep that atmosphere in prayer and consecration. If you want to be near to God, read your Bible every time, pray every time. Okay, may God bless you. We can stand now and pray. So those who did not experience the Holy Spirit, keep on praying. Say to God, God, I want a new birth. I want to die on myself and be a good Christian, a good child of God. Those who receive the Holy Spirit, now you need to keep your atmosphere good. You need to pray every day. You need to read your Bible. You need to watch out. Watch and pray. The Bible says, watch and pray. May God bless you. Okay. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. And thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Siyabonga. 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 Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Close your eyes and pray now. Ask God to give you the true Holy Ghost. Take a decision. Do not wait. Do not do like Nicodem, who's coming and asking Jesus to be. Salvation is about yourself, not mommy, not daddy. You will be alone on that day. Keep on asking. Keep on begging. Keep on knocking, keep on asking, it will come because it's the promise of God. Lord Jesus, we are too thankful to you again, speaking to our kid, Lord, knowing that the Bible has spoken about this,
that in the last day, children will be rebellious to the parent, Lord. But we're coming in this few words to ask again your Holy Spirit to come down upon our children, Lord. May they be filled with the Holy Spirit and take decision to come and take the course and follow you. Lord, would you please grant it? You say in the word that you never chase those that are coming to you. And because your promise, we believe in the true Holy Ghost in the heart. And that transforming power is going to transform our children, Lord. Come and honor your word. Come and dwell in us. Come and circumcise the soul, the heart. As you say in Ezekiel, you will give us a new heart. Lord, we surrender all our children into your hand. Forgive them, Lord. Help them, Lord. The will and the desire come from you. We thank you again for this opportunity. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. God bless you. I'm going to leave the people to Papa for that.
Shalom, shalom, papa. Shalom, dear parents.
Na pesi bino susumote na komo kona Jesus na tonga lelo.
Once more, I greet you all in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ this morning.
To remesi zambi na bana na bisoba papa poki apiso sufe devi.
We both parents and children thank God for the breath of life He's given us once more.
Is a gratitude pour ça de locomoto ici bon monde.
It's actually free of charge because we haven't given him anything.
Et voilà pour le bien merci Seigneur Jésus Christ.
That's why we say thank you Lord Jesus Christ.
Et voilà pour le bien bana thank you Jesus.
And that's why we always sing the chorus thank you Jesus for the
children.
For everything He's done for us.
Alors là, il faut passer à pour ya Sunday school.
Here is the report of our Sunday school of this morning. We are still talking about the Holy Spirit. And today's monitor was Mama Ruth Ndongala. As she stood here, she opened the Bible in John 3.
3-6.
From 3 to 6.
Atalipe Ecclesiastes 36.
She read in Ecclesiastes 36 as well.
6 à 7.
From 26 to 27.
Mais toujours, maman, car vous t'as dit si, pourquoi le Saint-Esprit?
And we're talking about what was the Holy Ghost given for. And she has taken something very important to show to our children.
Il fallait que la nouvelle naissance.
It's actually about the new birth. That's why if you open the Bible, what you did with the children. It's a very important question
for us to read
to the children. It was somebody whose name was Nicodemus. He was one of the chiefs of the Jews. And he came to ask to the Lord Jesus Christ what to do in order to receive the
so
Holy Ghost.
Was in verse 3 in the Bible.
In verse 3 it says this.
Please let me read it.
It's a question and answer. It says this.
In John 3,
in John 3 verse 3.
Jésus lui répondit.
That Jesus answered.
En vérité, en vérité.
Verily, verily.
En vérité, je vous l'ai dit.
Verily, verily, I say unto
si un homme né de nouveau,
unless a man be born again,
ne peut voir le royaume de Dieu.
He cannot see the kingdom of God.
Voilà qui question.
It was a question that was asked to
him. Lui n'a commis mon colbe. Comment a fait quoi?
And Nicodemus told him, I'm old as I am now. How can I go back into my mother's womb?
Is that lesson
it's the lesson that's monitored.
We
have an example of a human being. We have the body. The spirit. And the soul as well. She showed to the children how the body is operating. And she also showed how the spirit works. You cannot see your soul within you. It's like faith. It's very important for you to show these things to the children. Now to receive the
Holy Spirit,
one should die out from all evil things. And she quoted all the evil things which are not conformed to the word of God. Then the Holy Spirit will come and dwell in you.
A petit exemple, il y a Frère Branham de Maloba qui utilise des chiens.
She has given the example that Brother Branham
gave on the
dogs. There are actually two dogs, black and white. Yeah. You will know the one that you feed the most. If you have the Holy Spirit, you will see what is leading you. She said you should die out of all the things, and then the Holy Spirit will come. Because as you are with the children, a child may be playing hypocrisy. He knows that the mother goes out at such a time, and the father goes out at such a time as well. Now, when they remain themselves, they will play, switch on the TV. And they know that mama will come back at some time. You see how hypocrisy works. Therefore, we're asking our children to make up their mind so that they receive the Holy Spirit. We don't want any hypocrisy amongst them. We don't want them to follow the bad friends. That's what the monitor taught this morning. May God richly bless her.
It's a sacrifice.
Really sacrifice. May God bless her and give her her heart desire.
Alors, nous avons fait ça, disons, nombre de garçons puis de filles.
The number of boys and girls was as here.
We're
mixing both the first and second classes as we are together. With the little children, they should be involved as well.
Okay, number of girls are 17.
We had 17 boys.
Number of girls are 11.
We had 11 girls.
Today, 15 Bibles.
We had 15 Bibles. And we've collected 27 rand as offering.
La cotation ya Frère Branham to bojina.
And the quote from Brother Branham was read in the seal.
Le 10 465.
On the 10th of April, 65.
Paragraphe 45-57.
Paragraph 45-47.
Voilà ce qui vous en angola par téléphone à une bordalone libre aux oies place toujours basé sur un signe Saint-Esprit.
You'll find what we're talking about on the Holy Spirit once you go to this.
Valet balana qui se bat beaucoup à l'issue.
Our children should be born again.
Par le bon
by seeking the Holy Spirit.
Pambate toi, quand par la mouline, nous attendons au pasteur à jour.
And then they will be led by this Holy Spirit as the pastor is teaching us and so as we are also teaching.
Tomoni frère Branham.
If we see Brother Branham,
comme si les, que le Saint-Esprit,
speaking on what is the Holy Ghost,
alliance,
we said it's a covenant,
avocat,
it's our advocate, he gave a lot of titles,
because
the advocate is the one who pleads
is
for you,
pour
and it's also a promise for
ticket
us,
pour
it's our ticket. May God bless you.
Voilà tout ce monde.
Let's pray God. Our Heavenly Father, we thank you this morning. Lord, we are led by your Holy Ghost. And we want our children to be born again. Therefore, our desire is that when we leave, we may go with our children. That's why we thank you this morning. Bless the monitor. And bless our Sunday school as well. And may you bless each and everyone that is
working
in Sunday school. We want the Holy Ghost to lead us on how to bring these children up so that the world has got to be
and
we may show the way of your words to our children.
That's
why when we are at home, we
make
sure our children how to follow you.
Therefore,
bless all parents wherever they are at this time with the children. And may you grant the deepest heart desires.
We
also ask you to bless our servants, and all the offices that are working around
them.
God, we really want you to give us the Holy Ghost and give us your oneness and the fear of your word, that we may love one another. For all in all, may glory, honor, praise be given unto you, as we have asked in Jesus' name.
Savior say, thy strength indeed is small. Child of weakness, watch and pray. Find in me thine all in all. Jesus paid it all. All to him I owe. He washed it white as snow. Jesus.
die.